Preview deploys from companies like Vercel, Netlify, Cloudflare, and more make it easy for you to see every commit in your Git tree as a live production deploy. But this can make things difficult when integrating with other services that require a redirect URI. We get a lot of questions about this from developers looking to connect hosted AuthKit in their preview deploys. So today, I'll show you a quick and foolproof way to connect the two. Let's get into it. On screen, I'm running the local version of my personal site, and if I attempt to visit the dashboard, I'll be redirected to my hosted AuthKit login page. If we investigate this URL, we see a handful of query parameters, including my client ID, as well as a redirect URI. This URI is obviously encoded, but if you look at it, you can see that we're sending users back to localhost port 2426/auth/callback once they've been authenticated. Of course, this is a known value in my local environment, but it's dynamic in a preview deploy setting. So let's go to Cloudflare, where this site is hosted, find a preview URL, and open it up. Now, when I attempt to visit the dashboard page in this preview deploy, we get an error. Now, what we need is a way to get this dynamic URL for this specific build into two places, our sign-in URL and our WorkOS dashboard. So let's copy it and navigate to our WorkOS dashboard where we will visit the redirects page. Here we see our local URL in our allow list. So let's add our preview deploy. Now preview deploys follow some type of pattern. This is the site and the domain. And before that is the ID of the build. This is the part that's going to change most frequently. So we'll represent the dynamic part with an asterisk, which we can see is used as a wildcard value. Add that and we should be good on the WorkOS side. Now let's take a look at the code. On our sign-in page, we are redirecting to an AuthKit authorization URL, which we get through our AuthKit local library package. So let's inspect that function. The get authorization URL requires three pieces of data, the provider, AuthKit, the redirect URI, and the client ID. Now, because we want a dynamic redirect URI, I'm gonna cut this and call an accessor function. We'll then write a function that checks if we even have a WorkOS redirect URI in our environment, return it if we do, and throw an error if we don't. Now, this is where it gets interesting. In Cloudflare, we can add a second condition that will check for the preview deployment URL. In Cloudflare, that's cf_pages URL. And in this case, render the preview URL with our URI segments attached to the end of it. With this function in place, we can now leave our WorkOS redirect URI environment variable undefined only in our preview deploy environment and depend on this CF pages URL instead. Let's save this, commit, and push. Now back on our hosting platform, we'll see this new build. And once it's deployed, we'll see a unique build URL. This time, when we try to visit our dashboard and get redirected to AuthKit, we find success. And find in our redirect URI parameter, the proper dynamic preview deploy URL. This means that we can log in and be directed back to this specific preview deploy. So that's all you need to do to make sure that hosted AuthKit is available for all of your preview deploys. If you found a particularly good article on how to do this for your specific platform, please put them in the comments below. I'm sure others would love to see them. And if you have other questions, we'd love to hear them and help you get started with AuthKit. I'm Jantastic. I'll see you in the next one. Bye.